Hi, welcome to CATIA V5 video tutorial. I want to do the front wing, the Formula One front wing exercise now in CATIA V5. I had to do it slightly different because with the multi-section surface it didn't work. So let's have some fun with CATIA V5. I will need some geometrical sets, so maybe one for the planes, another one for sketches, another one for curves, and one for surfaces. And I might also need more than one body, so I will insert another body and another one. Let's rearrange those. Let's move these up. Should be able to them both at once, but okay. Now make the planes the active geometrical set, and I want to insert some planes, one with a distance to that one, let's say 800, another one, so double click right here, one with a distance to this one, maybe 60, one to that one at 610, and another one at -610. Cancel this out. Okay, now sketch. I go for a positioned one on that plane. Oh, that's okay. Hide those yellow projected elements. And I want to go for a rectangle. And I don't want to use those horizontal and vertical constraints as usual. So I delete them. Now this could be 300, make it symmetric to the axis, and this one should be coincident in that plane. And I need a distance, and this might be 400. Let's switch this to construction and use a 3-point arc. Okay, and this should be like this. Now I could trim. This should be symmetric as well, and the radius might be 200 or 250, let's see. Yeah, that's okay. I want to do the fillets in the sketch, so you could select two of them or even four of them. One point, second point, third point, fourth one, go for fillet, and maybe 50, yeah, that's okay, and leave that sketch. Now another sketch on that plane here. sketch here on that plane. And orientation is okay, yes. Hide these as usual. Now this could look something like that one might be 250, this might be 150, this could be aligned with that axis, and those two could be symmetric. And if I want to use fillets, let's see what's missing here. Yeah, that distance. This could be 300, perhaps. Yeah. Now let's add some fillets. Make this one. It will delete those two dimensions. So I want to go for all four points. You could go with the user selection filter. And I want to have a fillet, and that might be 40. Yes. Yes. Okay. Leave that sketch. Now I want to do surfaces, so I switch to that geometrical set and I want to use a blend. But first I should make an extrude. So let's switch to GSD and I want to make a surface extrude with this sketch. That's okay. And another one with that sketch in the opposite direction, and okay. Now I will hide those sketches. Because I want to use the edges for my blends. I tried to do it with multi-section surface without guides. That didn't work, and with guides I didn't get a very good result. So I go for a blend or more blends. First blend should start with this edge and that support right here. That surface, okay. And the second curve would be that edge and this support. And you have to change the tension. So I will go for, let's say, first one should be okay, but the second one should be, let's say, 0.5. Let's see if this works. Yes. Yeah, 0.5 is okay. And confirm. Next one. And yeah, that's an arc and that's a straight line, so I should maybe change that sketch to an arc as well, but I can take a look how it would look like. So go for blend. This edge and that surface. To that edge and this surface. Yeah. I wanted to use the edge, not the axis system. So go over here That's more like it. Let's take a look. Yeah, looks okay, and I could change it to an arc as well. If I change the tension, change it back to, let's say, 0.5 is okay. Looks good. Okay. Next, I want to make multi-section surfaces, and I would like to use those edges here. I could extract them, or I could simply go for a join. You can join the edges. So let's start with this arc, that line, this arc. Okay. And another join, this arc, that line, this arc. And that's awkward. Now it's okay and okay. Those two should be in the curves set, so change geometrical set to curves. We have to select it because it's not selected. Okay. Same on the other side, so like this, and make another join. This edge, and this one. Okay, so that seems those two should not be in the selection. Okay, same here, join this arc, that line, this arc, and okay. Okay, now let's go for a multi-section surface. I want to use that join, but you should always go from the smaller to the bigger one, so use this one and that one. Use as support that extrude. Use for that support this extrude. Then go for guide. Use that edge and that surface as support. And this edge and that surface. See if this one works. Great. Same thing on the other side. I could change this to a different style, more like this. Okay. And of course I should control the, where is it? The coupling. I should go for tangency then curvature. That's better. Now the same thing over here, another multi-section surface from this join to that join. Use this support, that support. Go to guides, that edge, this support. This edge, that support, and go for tangency then curvature, and okay. Very nice. Maybe I should change the first sketch, but those two should be in that geometrical set, so just move them over here. I want to change sketch 2. Let's see if we can control it with that dimension. Let's go for 100. See if it works. Yeah, it's okay. You could change those values anytime, of course. Now I want to hide the extrude and the other extrude as well. Or I could use that one so I got a little bit more room. So let's make this 10. And make a fill. Or just go for a boundary. Go for a boundary. Tangent continuity with that one. Okay. Then make a fill, the boundary, and okay. And of course, the boundary should be in the curves set, and that would be okay. Now let's hide this one, hide the joint as well. And make a join this surface, that extrude, this one, this one, and that one. Okay. That join is a surface, so put it right there. Now let's make an edge fillet, not a B-tangent, an edge fillet, this one, and go for 10 should be maybe possible. Yeah. Great. Now switch to part design and thicken the thick surface, the edge fillet. So this will be in a body. Make it 5. Let's take a look. That looks good. Hide that one, and this will be in the part body right now. So I want, yeah, that's the main body, that's okay. Nice. And I know that isn't straight, but gives it a different look. This might be not the best possible shape for F1 front wing spoiler, but if you want to control this, you will have to add more guides, or you could change the values or the angles, whatever. Okay, next is a sketch. On the YZ plane, okay. Hide those. And that would be a circle. A line. And an arc. Maybe like this. Make those tangent, tangent, and I don't want that horizontal constraint, so trim that. give it some dimensions. This could be maybe 15, and that one should be aligned horizontal. Therefore, I will need a small line here, which is horizontal. It's just for construction, and I don't want this. So I have to make a distance to that axis, and that would be swap location like that, and make this maybe 5. Yes. Then give that a radius, maybe 1800. That's even bigger, so I'll make it smaller on 500, on 300, no, on 100. Still too big, so I should go for a different dimension, not the radius, but the distance from this point to that point might be a better idea, and make this 150, for example. And of course, it should be horizontal. And this one should be up here, and I'm missing the tangency, so this one and that one should be tangent. That's more like it. So this one and that one should be not a distance, but parallel. Okay. And that might be 130. And somehow I managed to lose that. This should be parallel to that one. Okay. Now make an extrude. This will happen in that body. I might go for a different body, so go for this body. Sketch should be here, yes. Okay, that sketch. No, sorry. An extrude. That sketch. Up to a plane like this. And in the other direction, up to a plane like that. And okay. Great. Let's go for another body. I want a sketch on that plane. Hide those yellow projected elements as usual. And that would be another circle. Diameter maybe 30 as well. and then I need two circles. This, oh, that was not my intention. I want to delete that tangency, and this might look something like that. Yes, make those two tangent and move this one. That, make those two tangent, then trim, of course this should be aligned. Horizontal. So that one and this one should be parallel. That's for construction only. Let's move this up a little bit and give it some dimensions. Move this up, maybe like this, leave that sketch. Now I need a copy of this one, so that sketch should be not here but there. Copy this one and paste it onto that plane. Open the sketch and change the values. So this might be 90, and this might be not 80 but 40 or 30 or even less, 25. Yeah, that's okay. And leave that sketch. Now I could go for a surface extrude or for bodies. I will go for surface. So switch to GSD. Go to surfaces and make an extrude with this one. Reverse the direction, make it, let's say, 70. Another extrude with this one. That's not visible, so I have to hide that big body here. Okay, maybe 80. Yeah. Now another blend from this edge. It should propagate, but it doesn't, so I will make an extract with tangent continuity. Like this, okay. I could go for a join, of course, and another extract here. And okay. Okay, so let's try to add another blend. I want a blend from that extract with that support to this extract and that support. Let's take a look. Yeah, looks okay, but not brilliant. So go here and make it tangency, then curvature coupling. And okay, this looks pretty good. Now I could change the tension, maybe to 1.5. Let's try. Yeah, this looks really good. Okay, now let's join these. 1, 2, 3. Okay, and now you can close that surface. So go for body 3 and close that surface in the part design. Close surface, I want to close that surface. That would be the join 6. And okay. Hide that one. Now I could mirror this one. So I am here. I want to mirror. Where is it? Here we go. Mirror that body. So just select plane. It will take the current solid. This looks really good. Okay. I could go for a fourth body, so insert another body. And of course, reorder the children once more. And move that last body up. Another sketch. On the Y set plane. Hide those yellow projected elements. And this could look something like that, for example. Now let's add a fillet here, maybe like this. Add another fillet over here, maybe like that. Delete that one and make a circle and trim. Maybe like this. It's just an example. And make this 70. No. let's move this a little bit. Maybe like this. Leave that sketch. Let's make an extrude. Yeah, but make sure you're in the correct body. That would be body 4. Okay, now let's make the extrude with that sketch up to a plane, to this plane, and the other distance should be here -605. Yeah, looks pretty good. With the same sketch, another extrude, again up to plane, but to this plane, more on that dimension should be 605. Yeah. Now let's hide the sketches. The curves. And the surfaces. Okay. And show body 1. The part body. And now I could assemble them or add them. So let's go for assemble. 1, 2, 3. Assemble that to the part body. And okay. Switch to different style. And I'm done. And I could add the planes as well. So I hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook cat fan page. And please like it over there. Would be very nice of you. Thanks for watching. See you to next one. Bye bye.